You know, it's kind of funny what the right arm does and what it doesn't do in the golf swing. You know, if I just ask you, George, show me what the right arm does in the golf swing. What's your opinion of it? What does it do?
It's just, the left arm does most of the work. It's just there to kind of guide a little bit, and it should be fairly loose and relaxed.
Okay. But what does it do? Like, show me the motion it would make. Put your left hand in your pocket.
My left hand in my pocket?
Okay, that's pretty good. You know what most people do? They do something like this.
Thumb right up, arm. Thumb up, thumb forward. Right thumb up at the back, thumb up at the...
Okay. I would say the opposite about the left arm, right arm. I'd say the left arm, you know, does very little in the golf swing. You know, it's kind of an inert thing that just kind of hangs there. And the right arm is really kind of what support... If I overbend my right arm, look what my left elbow does. People always talk about keeping their left arm straight. The right arm knows what it's doing. The left arm always stays straight. You know, so if the right arm's always got a little bit of what my coach used to call extensor action, just the ability for it to always want to be straight. I never bend my right arm. I would tell you that, you know, like years ago, somebody'd say the moon's made of cheese, right? And they believe that. I would tell you my right arm doesn't bend. My right arm is always straight. That's what I would tell you. Now, I know in video that my right arm bends. Okay, but the sensation of my golf swing is that my right arm is very, very straight. I look in the video and I'm amazed to see that it's actually bent. So that extension of the right arm, that feeling of length in the right arm is what actually keeps the left arm kind of straight. But more toward, you know, with Savannah just now, we're kind of looking at a couple backswing positions, just kind of refining her swing as it's starting to look amazingly better in a short period of time. But the right arm, you know, if you were to say, how much is this particular spot on my body moving? Let's just say, you know, if I could put a big red dot right there, if I took a piece of painter's tape and put it there just to make it a little bit more vivid. So this spot, you know, so I've got Savannah's wedge. I'm going to hit this wedge 120 yards. How much is this spot really moving to hit this shot that far? You know, how much is it really moving? Is it going, you know, maybe 8-9 inches around to the right, maybe a little bit back up, down to a ball, back up around? It's kind of a pretty small little motion. Okay, and part of the reason I'm kind of going into this discussion is to say that, you know, to strike shots correctly and with enough energy to play good golf. Golf doesn't have to be this big, wild game. You know what I mean? Like in your case, Lance, we're trying to take your swing and maybe take it from here and maybe move this green dot another couple inches, inch maybe. And that's going to give you distally like a lot more speed once you start to engage from the ground up. But it's funny how little a swing has to be. Like in your swing, George, your swing does a lot more work than it really needs to. And that's why you're probably not as consistent as you'd like to be. There's tons of power in your golf swing. You saw that yesterday as you know, with some of your new impact alignments, you constantly flew it over greens. You hit it over 4 or 5 greens yesterday, right? You know, so for you to say, okay, yeah, I'm satisfied hitting 9-iron 160. It's a long way to hit a 9-iron. Expect, you know, at this altitude, maybe it's 145 in the Bay Area. But, you know, the golf swings, it's not a huge motion to take this green dot. You know, literally not very far and back to a golf ball. And you're saying, well, yeah, it's oversimplifying it. It totally is oversimplifying it. There's a lot that goes into it. You know, good hands, some rhythm and balance, good impact alignments. But just to kind of make you aware of some of the smallness of a good shot, you know, and how tiny things can be to hit things a long way. You know, so how far is what's my left shoulder doing in this motion? How far did that go? You know what I mean? Is there a whole lot of randomness going on with my backswing and how I'm getting there? No. It's it's kind of organized and it's kind of simple. And that's, to me, the best way to play. Now, of course, if I took this green dot and put it at the club head, you know, that's the thing that obviously does the most travel. And in my case, it's probably going to about here, you know, and then to the golf ball. It's not certainly trying to be John Daly-esque in any way, right? So smaller, organized strikes, you know, provide, you know, all the power we're going to need. All the power we're going to need. You know, John, I say John Daly set the game back years. Because when he came on, he hit it so far, played really well with this crazy long, exaggerated golf swing. Of course, kids went, oh God, I want to hit it like that. But if they would have, you know, if they would have modeled a guy named Dan Pohl, who maybe didn't win as much, who hit it equally as long, Dan Pohl's swing was this far and hit it every yard John Daly hit it, except he didn't win two times in two majors and, you know, he didn't look as flashy as this goofy redneck blonde guy, right? But, you know, it's amazing how small the golf swing really is to hit it effectively. I know we can all move our shoulder this fast. I know you can, I know you can. Okay, so I know that, you know, you said, yeah, man, you hit a lot of great shots yesterday, you know, right at the pin. I know you can, I know you can, I know you can. You can do the same thing. You can do that little motion at the same speed I do it. Okay, maybe Savannah doesn't quite have the arm strength yet to support that speed yet. But, you know, next year, the year after, you will. You know, you'll naturally just get stronger as you get a little bit older. And, you know, with some physical stuff, you'll get stronger anyway. But in your case, George is, you know, his backswing gets so long. And the trade-off is just more wild shots as opposed to crisp, good strikes, you know. Mm-hmm. So anyway, sorry for my little rant. I just wanted to kind of go over that with Savannah. I figured it'd be good for you guys to hear it too.